Christos, we saw how easy it was to use identity when we are creating web app, but is it different? What do we need to do differently when we're talking about APIs?
Well, quite a few things have changed in the .NET space, and you know, .NET 6 is just around the corner, which is super exciting. But when creating APIs, the major difference is that there's no UI to interact with. So your APIs need to still be secure, and they need to check for certain things. First is that the token is valid, and secondly, that the incoming access token contains the right permissions. Sometimes people only do half of it, and then you know everything is fair game once they pass through the door. So always make sure that you check for certain permissions as well. And this time I'm gonna show you how to do a .NET 6 minimal API, which is super fun, just using Azure Active Directory B2C. So in this instance, we're gonna be using consumer accounts, not an Azure Active Directory account that is part of your organization. So maybe a web app or a mobile phone app calls into an API to grab some data from a backend. And I'll show you how to do this. So again, if we switch to my console, we'll do .NET new web API. And then here we're gonna do dash-auth, but this time I'm going to do individual B2C.
Okay.
And this is going to create our API and we will open it in code. It opens a new window, which is always fun. Too many screens, that's the problem. Let's say that. And you notice that there's only program, there's no startup.cs, and there are a few things missing, like top level namespaces and stuff like that. I see controllers here, and I don't like controllers, so let's remove them. No controllers. We'll add everything in line. Just like Node. If you've done Node before, then you know that Node APIs tend to be inline sometimes to make our life easier. And the app settings are going to be slightly different this time because we are using B2C, so there needs to be a sign-in and sign-up policy. We're going to cheat a little bit, and we're going to go copy-paste because I want to show you exactly how things work. So first of all, let's grab the settings. And then we will jump to Azure Active Directory B2C to show you where these are coming from. So we have our API app registration like we did before, and I will show you that in a bit. And then we're going to add some code in the program.cs. So here I'm just gonna grab my code and we're gonna dump it into program.cs. Mm-hmm. Control A, Control V. So what's happening here? This is not the right name. I need to use that namespace. And then you write it here. And you notice that again, we brought everything in here where we are still using the authentication. This time we're doing web API. We are also configuring cores because if you're gonna be calling your API, you need to have cores, otherwise you're gonna fail and you don't wanna be caught by that. And then we have one public endpoint, the MapGet weather forecast, right? And then in here, we're doing two things. One is we're requiring authorization. So we need to make sure there's an access token passed in our request. If that's not there, then we're gonna get a 401. But inside here as well, we also say that any incoming request needs to have a valid scope. So not only do I need to authenticate against Azure Active Directory B2C, but I also need to have the right permissions in my account. And in here, the permission is access as user. So let's jump very quickly to Azure Active Directory B2C to see how this is configured. So we have the minimal API .NET, that .NET 6. So I'm clicking on this one. And in here, let me zoom in a little bit. We are exposing an API. That's the API here. And that's the fully resolved API namespace. And that's what is used by our API right now. And then we also have an app registration for our client, like something that is calling our API. And we'll use one of the Visual Studio Code extensions to actually run a demo. But here we have the authentication, which is going to be using Thunder Client and VS Code. And under API permissions, we do have that API that is coming from our API, and we've consented to that because users cannot consent in B2C. And with that, we're ready to actually test it. So let's go back into our code and run the API. Let's see, actually, no. Is VS Code going to barf? Because I think there's one thing missing from here. And I think what is missing is the fact that, oh no, it's here. Implicit usings enabled. If you don't do that, then it's going to complain about missing namespaces or missing usings. The fact that it's there, it's all good. So yeah, we're ready to run it. So .NET run. Is it going to open a random port again? I'm curious.
Like, I'm assuming it will be the same port.
Well, you know what they say about assumptions. Let's see. I think because it's an API, we don't really have a redirect URI, which is great. It just means that we can go directly and test it. So it doesn't really matter. Yes, there's no redirect URI here. So that's good. Okay, but we need to go into our VS Code now and use Thunder Client. Thunder Client is one of my favorite tools because it allows me to test things quickly without having to worry about having a separate tool here for API. So I think it's at the very top. Just need to change the port number, which I don't remember. Do you remember what? I think it's 7148. Obviously, here I've got my authentication configuration, which you can't see because everything is so minimized. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you guys can see it. But I am actually using my app registration settings in B2C to authenticate. So I'm going to generate a token. Yep, that's generated token. So if we close this one, save successfully. So now I have a valid token and now I can call my API and it will fail. The tenant ID option must be provided. Tenant ID token, that should be provided in the configuration, I think. Do we not have that? Oh, tenant ID, fine. I didn't think that we needed that before. Did something change in the code? Tenant ID. And we can find that in the portal.
But like that shows also that it like the error kind of error message if something is missing, so we can see that.
Yeah.
Grab the information, same page in the portal, like it's a one stop for all. We just add the line in the config, rerun, and it should work now.
It should. You're absolutely right. It should. Let's find out.
No pressure.
So here, let's send again. And there you go, that's data. So things have slightly evolved, but the good thing is that, again, it doesn't take much to configure an API to make us more secure.
Well, thank you. And now let's go back to Studio for more questions.